y'all, it's Ilana, and welcome back to my channel. So this is probably going to be the most controversial video that I post on my channel, but I want to talk about it because I think it's important to talk about. So it is about if being a feminist affects your dating life. Does it hurt your dating? Does it not even make a difference? There are so many misconceptions and perceptions on feminism, and I just sort of want to debunk this. I understand that I'm not going to be able to change people's opinions after they watch this video, and that's okay. I just ask that in the comments section that you remain very respectful. You do not say anything misogynistic, misandrogynistic, racist, discriminatory, sexist, things like that. If you feel like you disagree with me on anything, you can use very polite language or constructive and productive language without sounding insulting and malicious. So that is my request for you, but if I see that the comment section goes way out of hand and it's extremely malicious and not productive, then I'll have to shut the comment section off, and I don't want to do that. So without further ado, let's go ahead and talk about this. Before I just say, does being a feminist affect dating? I just want to quickly talk about what feminism is and what it isn't. And again, I understand this may not change people's opinions in any kind of light, but I just hope that you can hear me out in what I have to say. So let's just talk about what the true traditional meaning of feminism is and what it's supposed to be about. So feminism is literally about gender equality. It is about saying that men and women should have equal rights, opportunities, and responsibilities. And it allows both parties to be able to think, act, behave, and make decisions for themselves without anyone making those decisions and telling them how they should live their lives accordingly. That is basically what the true definition of feminism is. Now, it is not to say that equalness means the same. I know that men and women are not the same. Men and women are physically built differently. They think and feel differently, whether it's emotionally or mentally. I get that. I know men and women are not the same. And I think there's a big misconception when people will say that equality is sameness, and that kind of gets taken out of context. And I wanted to be able to just talk about how being equal doesn't necessarily mean being the exact same. I know that men and women aren't completely the same. I know that, and I really just want to stress that out to you guys that I'm very well aware of this. Let's talk about what feminism isn't and talk about how feminism has been misconstrued and how the definition has been severely tainted by bad apples. Let's talk about the first thing. Feminism is not about hating men. And I'm sure many people will still come for me in the comments and be like, no, yes it is! Feminism is all about man hating! Let me tell you something. Feminism is not misandry. Radical feminism, I personally don't even consider it to be real feminism, because the radical feminists are the ones who do way too much and they take it too far. There are a lot of bad apples out there that really have ruined what the name and the definition of feminism is. And it's really unfortunate. Don't get me wrong, I guess I can see why people could think it's about man-hating, because there are a lot of feminists out there, so-called feminists we'll say, who leave out men's rights. And I just want to say, as someone who lives by the true traditional definition of feminism, I can tell you this right now, I still care about men's rights. I'm very well aware that a lot of men out there commit suicide. A lot of men will serve longer sentences in prison, and that a lot of men experience homelessness. Men's issues should not be ignored, and true feminists out there will still advocate for men's issues. And I think that there is this misconception that there are so many feminists out there that say men's issues do not matter. That's not the case. And if there are feminists out there who are saying that, oh, we only care about women's rights and not men's rights, then they can't really consider themselves to be a feminist. Because feminism is about equality and caring about both people. The reason that it's called feminism is because back in the day, women were not getting treated equally like men. They weren't getting the same kinds of responsibilities and opportunities, and so that's why the word femme is in that sentence, but it still applies to both men and women. And I think some people just get really upset that the word femme is in the name, and that can be another reason as to why some people might think it's about man-hating and it's about putting putting men down. I promise you it's not about putting men down. I don't want to put men down. That is not how I live. I love and respect men. And I don't consider myself to be a misandrist. And if I hated men, then, you know, I wouldn't be dating men. Okay, let's move on to the next thing about what feminism isn't. It's not saying that women are better than men or that women are more superior to men or that women are trying to seek special privileges. They're not. They want the same privileges. They want the same opportunities. It's not to say that we believe that women are better. I do not think women are better, nor do I think men are better. Nobody is better than anyone else. And a real feminist will not advocate for special treatment. She's going to advocate for the same treatment, not the special treatment. And if there are women out there that are advocating for special treatment, then she should not be considering herself a feminist, because that is not of feminist values and beliefs. True feminist values and beliefs, that is. I also think another people who hate feminism are the ones that really don't understand what the true definition is, or they may happen to feel threatened by it. And I think that is why a lot of people get so scared of the word feminist, and they will immediately associated with something where the definition is not being in place. I think there are many people who have really ruined the definition of feminism, and even there are so-called feminists who have ruined it itself, and I personally don't believe that they are real feminists. I think another people who hate feminism are the ones who haven't firsthandedly experienced sexism or discrimination, and they'll say like, well, I haven't experienced this, I don't feel oppressed, therefore I don't need this, it doesn't exist. I'm so glad to hear that you have not faced any kind of sexism or discrimination, or that you don't feel oppressed. That is great, but there are other people out in the world, especially in other countries, where feminism is really needed, where women are treated horribly, and that women are below men in other places in the world. And that is what feminism is advocating for. And that is very important, and it's something that we cannot ignore. Just because it's gotten a lot better in the US, even though there's still more work to be done, in my opinion. I personally think that just because you haven't experienced it doesn't mean that we don't need feminism. Maybe you don't need it and you're living your life fine, but just think about how other people are being treated in this world today. So now that I've kind of given you my thoughts on what feminism really is about, let's talk about feminism in dating. A lot of people have claimed that feminism hurts traditional gender dating roles. I think that's BS. I think because of feminism, you get the choice whether you want to traditionally date someone or if you want to modernly date someone. I think that's fine, and I don't have any issues with traditional gender roles. Okay, well, I do a little bit, but if someone wants to live their life that way and they consider themselves to be more traditional and they prefer things to be done old-fashionedly, that's their prerogative. I respect that choice. That is fine, because if that's what works for them and that's what makes them happy, I have no issues here. Let's talk about how feminism does hurt your dating. There are three things as to why it can hurt your dating, and they kind of all tie together. So let's talk about the first thing. Let's say that you are a woman and you consider yourself to be a feminist. You go on a date with a guy and he says that he's not a feminist, or he believes in strong gender roles, or he really believes in the patriarchy. Feminism is totally against the patriarchy. If a guy tells you he's not a feminist, he believes in the patriarchy, he's going to expect his partner to do certain things because those are his values and beliefs. And if you are a feminist, you know that you don't support the patriarchy. So that is a relationship that is destined to fail because you're not aligned. So that's one way it hurts you. The second way that it hurts you is that you're dating someone who is simply uneducated about feminism. I think there are a lot of people out there who are really hesitant about dating feminists because they don't really understand what feminism is, or again, as I mentioned, they feel threatened about it and they feel that this is about being a man-hater. You are able to sway somebody and educate them on what feminism is, and they change their mind and they say, oh, okay, you know what, after all, I do consider myself to be a feminist. That could work, but if you're not able to sway, know that you're not going to be able to change somebody's opinion about certain values, and you shouldn't, because that's very, very detrimental. So just think about that and understand that if someone is uneducated or they refuse to educate themselves or to hear you out, that's not somebody that you want to date. The third thing that feminism hurts you in your dating is that you end up running into someone who is going to be very, very traditional, They are really for traditional gender roles, and they believe that men and women should be doing this according to earlier times. Someone is allowed to have those values and beliefs, but if someone is expecting you to change for them and expecting you to live by these values, you need to run. However, I do think it's possible that you can be traditional and still be a feminist. I don't think that these two things are correlated. And Felicia from the Feminine Fancy, I'll link her video down below. She did a great video on can you be a traditionally feminine woman and still be a feminist? And I thought it was a really great video. She didn't gender stereotype at all, and I really love her channel because she makes great videos about femininity. And I do care a lot about my femininity, and I love her videos because she does it in a very non-stereotypical way. And I personally think she's someone that you should go ahead and check out. I do think it's possible, but you have to just be careful on your values and beliefs. Say you are a woman and you do run into a traditional man who has these values that gender roles are the way to go. You really need to consider, is this someone that you can date because they expect things to be done like this? It's something that you're gonna have to take into consideration. I personally don't think it will work out, but if you're able to make it work, good for you. But if you're a feminist, please don't expect him to pay for all the dates and expect him to do all of this. And if he has an issue with you wanting to pay for one of the dates, then that's probably someone that you're not going to end up in a happy relationship with. So those are the three things as to why I believe being a feminist can hurt your dating. It's just because you're honestly meeting the wrong people who just simply don't fit your values and your beliefs. That is so crucial. So now let's go into why being a feminist has nothing to do with affecting your dating. So you're probably gonna know what I'm gonna say for the first thing is that if you are a feminist woman, it's really important that you find men who consider themselves to be a feminist and that they're all for gender equality and they feel that both parties have different issues that need to be addressed, and they also just respect women in general and they don't say anything that's misogynistic, right? I think that is totally fine. I don't think being a male feminist makes you any less of a man. I don't think it emasculates you in any kind of way. I don't think there's anything wrong with wanting to respect women, wanting to empower women, wanting to be there and care about women's rights while still caring about your own rights as well. I think it's such a shame that there are other people out there saying, oh, well, if a man considers himself to be a feminist, he loses his man card. No, it's just such BS. And I don't think we get to decide who loses their man card and who doesn't. You have no business in saying something like that. And that's why people belt out this term, toxic masculinity, because it's very toxic for you to tell somebody whether they're not being masculine enough. That's not your place to say, and it's most certainly none of your business on how someone chooses to live their life. The second thing about being a feminist that can empower you in dating is that feminism gives you the choice in who you want to date, right? If it wasn't for feminism, we would be forced to settle for less than what we deserve. And I don't think that's okay. You know I'm against settling so much. The reason that most women are single is just because they know their worth. And I'm really tired of people saying, oh, these feminists are gonna be so single and lonely when they grow up, they're gonna have a bunch of cats. Well, first of all, there's nothing wrong with having cats. In fact, there are more men these days that are getting cats over dogs. I'll link a study down below for you. I just don't understand why women are getting shamed for owning cats. I think this stigma is so stupid. Don't judge people for owning cats because it's perfectly normal to have a pet. And I don't think that these women are single and lonely. You think they may be single and lonely because you think that being in a relationship makes you a happy above all human being when it doesn't. So I'm 2 years away from being 30. And if I have to be single for the rest of my life, then I will be, because I am not going to settle for less than what I deserve. I deserve to be treated with love, kindness, and respect. And I want a man who is going to treat me as such. And if I keep running into men who are really mean and unkind and don't respect women or care about my value, then I'm honestly better off being single. And being single isn't a bad thing at all. A lot of the guys that I've dated in San Francisco, well, while they have had their own issues and as to why they didn't work out, meaning that a lot of them didn't really want a serious relationship while I did, that had nothing to do with feminism. That just simply had to do with us not being on the same page on a relationship intentions. But I would say that most of the guys that I've gone on dates with are for feminism. They do care about gender equality. They do care about respecting women. They care about men's rights as well, but they don't dismiss women's rights. To me, I think just caring about women and respecting women and thinking that women are of equal value, I think that is the sexiest thing in the world. And if a guy says women don't deserve equal treatment, women are less than men, that's not somebody that I want to date. I personally don't think that feminists have any difficulties with dating just because they're a feminist. I think feminists have just as hard of a time dating like everyone else because people are just absolutely complicated. I just hope that this has opened up your eyes in some kind of way. And again, if it doesn't, I'm really sorry I wasn't able to sway you in any kind of way. You're entitled to your own opinions. Like I said, if you disagree with anything that I've said, again, I ask that you use respectful language, non-malicious language, or hateful language in the comments. Let me know if you're a feminist and if it's affected your dating life or if you've had no problems dating. I'd love to know your thoughts. If you liked this video, make sure you give it a thumbs up, and I'll see you in my next video, y'all. Bye.